Hi everyone, and welcome to the Minnesota Orchestra's Young People's Concert Experience, American Voices. I'm Sarah Hicks, and I'm the Minnesota Orchestra's Principal Conductor of the Live at Orchestra Hall series. And we just heard a wonderful piece called Strum by Jessie Montgomery. Now, when I was listening to this piece, it felt to me like it sounded very American, and maybe you felt that way too. But why do we feel that way? Well, today we're going to explore music written by American composers and try to answer that question. In the piece we just heard, which is Strum, you might have noticed that the strings were pizzicatoing, plucking, and that created a really driving rhythm. And you may have also noticed that the melody hopped between different instruments. And both of these elements reflect the really high energy and busy movement and excitement of being in a big city. So Jessie Montgomery describes music in this way. She says, "I imagine that music is a meeting place at which all people can converse about their unique differences and common stories." So it makes sense that Jessie Montgomery, who was born and raised in Manhattan, would bring together all these elements, different sounds, different energy, different feelings from her experience growing up in a big city. So Jessie Montgomery was using the pizzicato of the strings to create a sound that was sort of like a folk guitar. Using traditional songs and folk instruments is one way in a piece of music that helps us feel connected in our shared American culture. Here's a traditional song that is part of our shared culture, and I think you're going to recognize this, so listen to this piece. That was Amazing Grace, a really popular folk melody, especially in Appalachia. Our next composer, Jennifer Higdon, spent a lot of her childhood in the South, and she says this piece that she wrote was influenced by her Southern upbringing. So Jennifer takes the melody I just played and uses it to create a piece that sounds like we're looking at a lot of different landscapes. Maybe it's a vast prairie, maybe it's a sunset or a sunrise, maybe it's rolling hills. By changing the harmony, Jennifer changes how the melody feels and sounds. So what I'd like you to do as you listen to this piece is to draw the images that this music brings to mind. So let's do some listening and drawing as we listen to Amazing Grace. Thank you. So what did you draw? Let's share what you drew with others and see, did you all draw the same thing? I'm thinking you didn't, because when we all listen to music, we all have different images in our mind. So as we go on with our concert, we can't talk about American music without talking about the indigenous peoples of our land. Our next composer, Lewis Ballard, was a Quapaw Cherokee Indian who was born in Oklahoma. And growing up, he experienced both native and non-native culture, and his music blends those two things. In this piece, Ballard combines the European traditional woodwind quintet with music, a funeral tune from the Tlingit Indians of Alaska, and it creates a piece of music that, like him, is a blend of two cultures. So the main melody that you're going to hear is played in a very special scale. It's called the pentatonic scale, and I'm going to play that for you on the piano. That was the pentatonic scale. It has a very particular sound to it. So now as you listen, I want you to write down all the feelings that come from this music, especially as the music changes. I'm really curious if your feelings change. So let's write and listen as we listen to music by Lewis Ballard. So let's look at what you wrote down during that piece and maybe compare it with others. Did you write down the same thing? I'm thinking that you didn't, because the amazing thing about music is two people can listen to the same music and have very different feelings. So far we've looked at how composers use folk music or styles from a region to take our minds to that place. And we've also talked about how the exciting things that happen when different styles of music are combined to create completely new styles. Our next composer did that very same thing. He's a Cuban-American composer named Paquito de Rivera, and he combined Latin jazz and classical music. This piece is a collection of dances, so it has a lot of dance rhythms, including something called syncopation. So usually we hear things like one, two, three, four. But the rhythm of syncopation means that we're on offbeats like this. One, two, three, four. So it creates this really exciting rhythm. while you're listening, I want you to make up a dance and move to the music. You can move, you can find the beat and move to the beat. You can respond to the dynamics, which is the loud and the soft, and you can find the mood of the music. And maybe as you hear different instruments, you can switch up your dance. So I want you to respond to this music through movement and just have a lot of fun. So I hope you all had a great time dancing. I know I did. Could you find that steady beat? So we've come to the last selection of our concert, and on our journey to discover what American music is, I think we found out that there's no one way or one style that captures all of America. And instead, we found many different styles and perspectives of American music. Our last composer is Steve Heitzeg, and he wrote a piece called American Nomad. And he describes it this way. He says, it's a series of soundscapes that depict various American landscapes. Steve Heitzeg is a Minnesota local, and he really enjoys traveling. American Nomad is inspired by travel, but we not only see scenery, but we also encounter the country's many different cultures. And maybe that's what makes it so interesting. All these different voices and perspectives means that there's always something new to hear, to explore, and to listen to. We hope you enjoyed our Young People's Concert experience that we'll see you at the next one. Thank you so much for coming along with us as we explored American voices. And I hope you enjoyed this last piece that takes us on a musical journey through America. See you next time.